Good morning, students. Before I start this chapter, I want to ask you that we are living in India. So what kind of rule is there in India? What are we practicing? We are practicing democratic rule. Only India, all over the world, is having democratic republic. Elsewhere, like China, South Korea, and United States, Arab states, all these are under the rule of one man army. That is, somewhere they are practicing kingship, somewhere it's a presidential rule, and somewhere there is a monarchy system. That means there is no such that the people are supposed to elect their own member as a president or a prime minister. Even these countries, the people don't follow the democratic, means they don't have the right to speak against the government. Only in India, it is a democratic rule. That means by the people, for the people, and of the people. As in earlier times also, most of the countries were governed by the powerful rulers and kings. And these rulers ruled according to their own personal wishes. The people were subject to follow the rules. They cannot change the rule of the kings. If they were speaking against kings, they were assassinated. Whereas now in India, after the Republic is on 26 January 1950, and when we were independent on 15th August 1947. In 1947, we were free from Britishers, but we didn't get the rules, or we were not following our own rules. But after 3 years, we got our own democratic rule. That is, on 26 January 1950, on this day India became a democratic republic. That is Purna Swaraj. The whole rules, laws were made by Indians. The constituents, that is the set of rules and regulations, rights and duties, that was under we people, we Indians. But it was not for, these rules were not set in one day and not by one person. It was set up with 389 members, and in July 1946, this Constituent Assembly was held. There were many eminent leaders also, as well as legal experts, and it included C.R. Jawaharlal Nehru, Rajendra Prasad, Sardar Patel, Maulana Azad, S.P. Mukherjee, Sardar Baldev Singh, Dr. R.S. Radha Krishnan, B.R. Ambedkar, Aladdin, Krishna Swami Iyer, K.M. Munshi, and others. And more than 30 members belong to the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. Then children, Frank Antony and Dr. H.P. Modi, they also represented Anglo-Indian and the Parsi communities. Not only men, but even women were the members like Sarojini Naidu and Vijay Lakshmi Pandit. Then the Constituent Assembly first session was held on 9th December 1946 and a second sitting by Assembly elected Dr. Rajendra Prasad as its chairman. During this time, Muslim League boycotted the Assembly and they demanded for their separate Constituent Assembly for Pakistan. And this Constituent Assembly reassembled with 308 members in 14th August 1947 at the Sovereign Constituent Assembly of India. Then there was a drafting committee. The principles of the proposed constitution were outlined by various committees of constituent assemblies. These assemblies were held separate discussions and submitted their reports. Now in this assembly also appointed 8 member drafting committee under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Then finally it presented the draft constitution in February 1948 and it was published all over India by Indian newspapers. Then they had a lot of debates for the constituent assemblies. By the clause by clause, they discussed about clause by clause. On 26 November 1949, the constitution was signed by the chairman of the assembly. Chairman of the assembly was, who was the chairman? It was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. And then the rest of the constitution came into force on 26 January 1950 and it referred as a date of commencement. The Constituent Assembly spent nearly 3 years and a sum of 6.4 crore in the drafting of the constitution. Now people were free to express their opinions and reactions through press. At that time, press played a very important role. Thus, the participation of the Indian citizens were in the process was ensured. The framers of the constitutions also studied the constitutions of the other countries like those of the France and the former USSR and adopted the principles that situated Indian needs. Birth of the Indian Republic. We celebrate 26 January as a Republic Day and it was on 1950. The Indian Constitution came into effect and Indian became a Republic. Now children, some of the important features of India's Constitution, that is democracy. The preamble to India's Constitution states that India is a democratic country. In a democratic country, the people govern themselves usually through their chosen representative. We Indians see today also when the members are standing for the elections, candidates are standing, that we people, Indians, they select the representatives accordingly. Means they don't select like that only. They see the work that is done by them and how much humble they are doing the work or not. Like this, we select the right candidate as our member, the Prime Minister or the President, MLAs, MPs, ward members. All these are selected by the people, but accordingly they see that how perfect that person is. That means by the people, for the people and of the people. Everything is in the hand of the people. Then, adult citizens of India, irrespective of their color, creed, caste, sex, religion or wealth, can vote in elections. That means the person who is at the age of 18, from that age, the person has the right for the vote to select the candidate. Then in a democratic society, everyone has to be treated fairly. For this, there has to be social justice, liberty, equality, fraternity. The Constitution of India therefore recognizes these are basic ideals. Social justice, children, that is the caste systems. It divides into the people into high and low castes. There are also great differences in wealth and injustice. Then you have liberty. The citizens of India have been granted the liberty to choose their own ways of life. They are free to express themselves and follow their own belief. Equality. All Indian citizens have equal rights and to have to obey the same laws. There is no other such law. All Indians have to follow the same laws, obey the same laws, irrespective of their color, creed, caste, sex, religion or wealth. All are equal. Fraternity. In India, there are various communities which have their own cultures and traditions. In order to keep the nation united, the Constitution of India promotes fraternity among the various communities. Here also same thing comes, though it is a fraternity, but equality in all everything. Secularism. All Indians follow many different faiths such as Hinduism, Islam, Christianity, Sikhism. Here the Constitution says that India is a secular country. That means that in India no religion is given importance over others. All are equal. There is no discrimination on the basis of religion and government and institution. Same as student, you go to school. Many religion students comes from many castes. Their colors are different. Their creed is different. But they wear uniform. For what they wear uniform? To have the uniformity. That nobody is rich or nobody is poor. Nobody is from the higher caste or the lower caste. All are equal. This is what the uniform is used in schools. The same way India, all the laws and rules are equal for everybody. There is no equality, no injustice for any caste or any creed. Nobody. All are equal. That means this symbolizes that we are Indian. We are from all, from one nation. This is what in the chapter, the Constitution of India. Read the chapter carefully, listen the video, and children, don't forget to subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon for the further notification. Thank you and have a nice day.